Hello friends, in this tutorial I'll explain how to do the setup of Oracle 19c data guard, and we will be doing this tutorial in parts, and this would be step by step setup of Oracle 19c data guard. To this particular tutorial, as I said, is divided into 5 videos. In this particular tutorial, the first part I'll only cover what are the steps involved to set up the data guard. In the next video, we will learn how to create the primary database and what are the requirements for the primary database. In the next video, the third video, we'll be covering the standby, and then we'll be enabling the MRP. And this would be the longest video because here we are creating the standby, and also we will be enabling the setting some parameters on the primary and setting some parameters on the standby. The next video would be data guard broker, and finally we will wind up with the fast start failover. So these are the 5 videos, and this particular video will cover the introduction part. So what we need to do as part of setting up of the data guard is, if you don't have the primary database, create one. The primary database that you created, normally it would be in no archive log mode unless you have created directly in archive log mode. But if you're not, then convert it into archive log mode, because data guard needs archive log mode. You have to enable the force logging. The force logging will guarantee that all the changes are captured in redo log file. So enable the force logging. Enable the flashback on. This is mandatory for fast start failover, and also it is mandatory for in the max availability or max production mode. And then you create the P file. Once you set up all of these parameters, you create the P file. You configure some entries in the listener, you configure the entries for the primary and standby in the TNS names.aura. The P file that you created from the primary, take the copy on the standby and edit it, and start the standby in no mount mode and perform the RMAN active duplication. When you do the RMAN active duplication, the primary has to be in target while standby has to be in auxiliary, and you will issue RMAN duplicate target database for standby command. Once that is done, you will be creating the standby control file. When these two parts are done, you now have a primary and standby. They are not yet connected, it's just that the standby has been created. So let me repeat. What we have done till now is we created a primary database, we converted it into archive log mode, we enabled the force logging, we enabled the flashback on, we copied the P file, we took that P file, started the database in no mount, we used RMAN active duplication for standby command to duplicate the database, and then we created the standby control file. Next part is, on the primary, we would be setting the data guard parameters. The log arc-1 for local archiving, the log arc-2 for archiving to standby service. Log arc config will include the unique name of the primary and standby. The FAL client will be local service name, and FAL server will be the remote service name. And standby file management auto to allow for the whatever files that we created on the primary gets automatically created on the standby. And you will also configure the standby redo logs, which is required for fast start failover, and also for max availability and max production, these two log files are necessary. So you will configure the standby redo logs as well. On these are the parameters that you will be setting on the primary. Similar, these particular parameters also need to be set on the standby, but they need to be in the reverse order. So on the standby, you would local arc-1 will be again local archiving, but it will be local archiving to the standby. Then you would have the log arc-2, which will be to the primary service. Then this parameter can remain same. FAL client would be the local service name, which would be on the standby, it will be sent by, and FAL server would refer to the primary. So you would set, and then once you set those particular parameter, you would be enabling the MRP. Once the MRP is done, then you will verify, you will perform some transactions on the primary, and then verify that those transactions have appeared on the standby. You will verify. So the steps, again I'll repeat: create the primary database, convert it to the archive log, turn on the force logging, turn on the flashback on, copy the p file, duplicate the database, set some of the data guard parameters, then set similar parameters on the standby and start the MRP, and you are ready to do your testing. The next part that we will be seeing, this will be the third video. This will be the third video where we will be setting up the data guard broker. To set up the data guard broker, we need to perform below steps. So we need to set this particular parameter to true on primary, the DG broker start to true on standby. We need to configure the DG broker config file. The particular file has default values. We can just accept those default values. Then we have to create the data guard configuration using dgmgrl command. So using dgmgrl command, we will create the data guard configuration and add the primary into that configuration. Then we will be adding the standby in the data guard configuration. We will be configuring the static connect identifier, which will be used by the dgmgrl client to connect to the standby, the database instances when it is starting them. Then we will be enabling the configuration and we will do a dummy switchover. We'll try to initiate a switchover using the data guard. So these are the steps that you need to do to configure the data guard broker. And in the last video, we will be checking how to convert the database or how to enable the fast start failover. The fast start failover can work in the max performance mode, but that's not recommended. So it should be in either max availability or max production mode. So we will change the sync, the logs transport mode to sync on the both primary and standby. We will be setting the production mode to max availability. We will be enabling the configuration. We will be enabling the fast start failover and we will be enabling the observer. So quite a lot to do. So I think I have covered what are the steps that are required. And as I go along, as I do those steps, I would refer back to this document, but these particular five videos will cover what we need to do as part of our Oracle Data Guard setup. I'll see you in the next tutorial, which will involve the steps which are required to create the primary. So that will be covered in the next video. Thank you for watching. See you in next video. Bye bye.